Hello people, this is Clown300, welcome back to another complaining video. You know how it is, whatever. I want to talk about something that I saw earlier because it pissed me off so much that I feel like I had to make a video on it. Before I begin, I want to say I already know how this video is going to get a lot of hate. Maybe not a lot, but just some hate comments. The guy I'm talking about today has one of those diehard rabid fan bases that I've ever seen on this website. Like, this is quite literally a David versus Goliath battle. Hasan Piker is one of those guys that I never see trending for any good reason, yet he's still somehow respected by a huge part of the community. Like, deadass, I get a little bit disappointed when I find out a creator I like is friends with him. And the reason I hate him isn't because of the politics that he has or whatever, like a lot of people do. It's because every time that I see him trending on Twitter, it's because he said something so stupid that it makes Keemstar look like a genius. And that's exactly what's happening right now. Like, earlier today, a clip from one of his streams went somewhat viral on Twitter, and I mean, just look at this.
Yes, a real job can be gruesome, a real job can make you very tired, but a real job doesn't suck the soul out of you, you know what I mean? In the same way that 9 hours of streaming absolutely will.
That is just insane to say. I made a video a long time ago on this guy named Kiamens, and this is literally the same thing that he said in his TikToks. And he was just being ironic. He was trying to sound as stupid as he possibly could.
I'm tired from what? Content creation is harder than your 9 to 5. You really don't know how much hard work goes into creating multiple videos a day. Being constantly creative with new video ideas, trying to make footage look good, getting new shots, taking many, many takes over and over, it can get to be a lot. So yeah, I'm tired.
And it's funny because all those videos people made in response to comments still fit in with what Hasan said.
But a real job doesn't suck the soul out of you, you know what I mean? In the same way that 9 hours of streaming absolutely will.
Some of y'all make life more difficult than it really needs to be. So let's think about it. If content creation is so hard for you that a 9 to 5 job is easier, go get a 9 to 5 job and quit creating content. Like, don't make it harder on yourself. Like, man, listen, this is draining. Go get a different job. You feel me? It's not that difficult, bruh.
I've been creating content full time for the last 2.5 years, and I'm telling you, it's not. You know what I did before I started creating content for a living? I ran my own construction company. That's right. I was a general contractor. I worked 16-hour days, physical hard labor, came home, worked even more doing bids, estimates, all kinds of shit, and then got like 2 hours of sleep and got up the next morning and did it again. Every single day, even on the weekends.
You are blessed. You should be grateful. What you do is simple compared to what a lot of people do. I had a job at a rice farm. If I wasn't as sturdy and big as I am, you would die, bro. And I'm being honest. Having to push and move almost 100 plus pounds every 10 minutes, bro. Be thankful for if this that this is your job.
So I saw this and I was like, ain't no way this is the full clip, because I mean, I've seen Hasan say some dumb shit before, but this? Like, this is on a new level. So I found a part of the clip after he said this, but I'm not sure how the guy who posted it thought that it would help his case. I'm going to trim out the parts that don't really matter since it's a 2-minute clip, but if anything, it makes what he said worse.
No. No, social battery wise, unless you're in fucking retail, it's very different. You're out of touch with them. I'm gonna die, dude. There's motherfuckers who are accountants in here and they're misunderstanding what I'm saying. A real job does not expend your social battery in the same fucking way as someone who did a sales job, a real job. I'm telling you, 9 hours of constant performance and people pleasing paps you out from social scenarios. After 9 hours of that, I could probably do fucking physical labor. It would not bother me, but I can't fucking do more social shit. That's my point. There are obviously real jobs out there that are good comparisons. Service sector, people pleasing jobs would be very similar. Those are like, I think, customer service type shit. But like, if you're an accountant, even like in sales, my interactions with clients was limited, way more limited than like constantly having to do this for 9 hours with like a back and forth interaction for 9 hours. That's what like sucks your social battery, and you just tap out after it. You give presentations for your job, right? Imagine giving a presentation for 9 hours straight. After a while, you'd be like, I don't want to talk ever again.
I mean, yeah, like I said, if anything, it makes him look worse. Because I feel like he actually did mean that content creation was harder than most real jobs. But once he saw how his chat reacted to it, he was like, actually, I meant it in the social battery sense. Which is still stupid to say. And this is what makes me think Hasan's never worked a real job in his life, because real jobs drain you in ways way worse than live streaming ever will. Especially if you're one of the biggest streamers on Twitch. And especially when your career was jump-started because your rich uncle owns a media company. When Hasan gets way too tired to keep going, all he's gotta do is shut the stream off and take a break. When someone in a real job feels like they're about to shut down, They gotta suck it up and deal with it. When Hasan gets told something he doesn't like, all he's gotta do is tell his mods to ban that guy.
My issue as a trans person is the fact that you, a guy that isn't super well-versed on trans shit, brought on a known transphobe knowing he might bring up transphobic shit. You aren't exactly a Vosh at trans debates. I hope that the rest of your life is as horrible as it is every single day, okay? There you go. Suck my dick. I despise you. I despise you more than anything else on the planet. You are fucking cancer, okay? You are cancer in this community, and you're cancer in every community.
When someone working a real job gets told some of the most vile shit that you'll ever hear in your life, they gotta suck it up and deal with it. I said I wanted these fries fresh. Ma'am, all you did was touch the outside of the bag. Bitch, I said make me some fresh fries. And even if you're like, you know what, I'm tired of working social jobs, I'm gonna get a job that involves physical labor, the toll it takes on your body is sometimes equally as bad, if not worse, than the mental pain from working a social job. Like, I've worked at a factory before where there's no socializing at all, and I think most people who work there would say that they would do content creation over working there. Cause there'd be days where all I would do is go to work, come back home, take a nap on the floor, take a shower, and then go to sleep. No socializing at all, yet I think most people would agree that they'd rather live stream than work there. I mean, it didn't help that I had and still do have sleeping problems, but that's not the point. Point is that there's so many people who have a metaphorical sledgehammer getting ready to smash their brain into a pulp if they ever stop working, and he's acting like he's a part of that group. His entire job is just calling the United States bad and reacting to other people's videos. Like, how the hell is that any way more draining than any of the working class jobs in this country? And it pisses me off because every time that a clip of him saying something stupid like this starts trending, so many of his fans find a way to make it so that what he said wasn't as bad as what he actually said. And I mean, I get it. If you like an internet personality, you're gonna want to defend them if something bad about them comes out. But this shit happens on a monthly, if not weekly, basis. Like, I've never seen someone say so much dumb shit like this and still have so many connections in the community. He lives in a $3 million mansion, and that, by the way, that's another stupid thing that he said. Back like 2 or 3 years ago, he reacted to Sniper Wolf's mansion, and when he saw the price, he was like, that is unimaginable wealth.
Dude, this is like unimaginable wealth, dude. How the fuck do people make this much money? $2.9 million near Las Vegas? Dude, oh my fucking lord, dude. You can buy a fucking castle in Las Vegas.
Yeah, like 3 or 4 weeks later, it comes out that he bought a mansion of nearly the same price as hers. And it wouldn't be as bad if he wasn't one of those guys that says eat the rich and stuff like that. Have you ever seen that picture of him in that ugly make the rich pay shirt? It's almost funny how ironic that is. Because if we're eating the rich, you best believe that I'm eating your ass first. Like, not like that, but he's a hypocrite of the worst kind because he's making people think that he believes in something that he really doesn't. All he does is call society bad. And when you ask him, hey, what are you going to do about it? He says, oh, you know, I'll spread the word about it. Yeah, man, thanks for your help. Most people my age will never own a house in their life. But yeah, you spread the word by playing Among Us with AOC.
I would say I solidified my success when I was able to get AOC on my show to play Among Us.
Because for real, tell me what he's done to actually help the people who he claims to support. Like, what has he done? He bought pizza for, what's it called, the writers in those protests? Like, do something with your money except collecting expensive cars and spreading negativity on the internet.
It's a proven fact that generosity makes you a happier person.
There's a guy on TikTok who paid these Mexican guys to hang out with him in Disneyland, and I love watching that shit.
We're at the Home Depot, see if anybody wants to come to Disney with us. Buscan trabajo. Buscamos a tres. El jale sí va a estar pesado. Vamos a ir a Disneylandia.
Okay. ¿Qué van a hacer a Disneylandia?
A disfrutar el día.
Okay.
¿Sí? ¿Sí? Y los vamos a pagar bien.
Because not only is he giving some hard workers a break that they deserve, it spreads positivity in a way that people like Hasan will never understand. He's never had to work hard for anything in his life. And I mean, be honest, do you think he'd ever go back to working a real job? His life of being paid to do mediocre coverage of news and stealing other people's content while sitting in a $3 million mansion like a fat gorilla means too much to him to go back to doing any real job. I think that's all I gotta say about the situation. I don't know how I ended up talking about this out of like a 2 minute clip. And I didn't even go into some of the other stuff like ducking Sam Hyde or that he has one of the most toxic communities on this website. And I know someone's gonna be like, oh, well, you're spreading negativity too, so that's ironic. Sometimes you just gotta be negative to get something through someone's head. There's no point in me being kind about this. There's been so many diplomatic videos about Hasan, yet they all get the same stupid comments. It's always one of two things. They either simplify your argument, or they attack you personally in bad faith. And I know there might be a comment like that on this video too. So which one is it going to be? Simplified argument or personal attack? I don't think this video is going to convince any of his fans that he's a bad person. Like I said, he says some dumb thing like this almost weekly and nobody ever stops to think, hey man, my other favorite creators aren't trending on Twitter every week for saying something stupid. Maybe this guy is problematic. I swear the only thing that will get people to see how bad of a person he is if it comes out that he molested like multiple people. And even then there would be a bunch of people saying, well, you know what? Maybe he didn't rape all those women. But yeah, I mean, that's all. I just wanted to get this out of my system because, I mean, like I said, this shit pissed me off so much. If you like this video or got just as bad as I did, smash like or leave a comment. Take care of yourself. Acknowledge me. Okay, bye.